Last week was huge for Airtable because they launched their new interface feature. It's incredible because it allows us to build a truly interactive experience for people on our team so that they can use our data in a better way. It's awesome stuff. And in this video, we're going to be hopping into how to build a dashboard with Airtable's new interface. I'm going to be breaking it down for you step by step about how you can use the charts and the numbers and the graphs and all the moving pieces together. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and I'm going to help you save up to 20 hours per week using no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about exactly how I help my clients and followers do that, check out the links below this video and you'll probably want to check out my upcoming automation webinar. So once a week, I actually hop on a live webinar where I teach the basic building blocks of automation. So we're going to go through how you can set up automation to do those repetitive, mundane tasks that you do day in and day out, freeing up your time so that you can focus on the big picture stuff. So if that's of interest, do check the link below or sign up at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. And even if you're not attending the live event, I'll be sure to send a replay to you if you sign up through that link. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video. This is big stuff. Now, before I get going into the actual demo of how to put together a dashboard here, I do want to say that when interface launched last week, you know, there were a lot of mixed responses that I heard in the community. And while my first impression was to compare interface to a true customer portal like Stacker or Softer, it didn't really live up to that particular expectation of mine. But the truth is, as I've gotten more and more into interface, I'm realizing it's a completely separate type of feature. You know, the Airtable interface, the goal of it isn't to get you into your own no-code system. The goal of this feature is to keep you inside of the Airtable environment. And from that perspective, it's really, really helpful for people who are using Teams inside of Airtable. If you're an enterprise user or if you're a larger Airtable client, there's a great chance that you've got tens, if not hundreds, of your teammates all together in Airtable. And from that perspective, this interface is a really, really powerful tool. So let's go ahead and jump into the interface feature now. And as I said, we're going to build our own sales dashboard. And before getting into it, basic overview of what we have. We have clients tying to projects. And importantly here, those projects are tying to transactions. So we are going to record multiple transactions as they are connected to a certain project. The thing that we're looking at for this particular dashboard is going to be sales data. Of course, you could build a dashboard from any kind of different data source that you have in your database. So let's pop into it. Upper left corner is where we find that interfaces feature, and we are going to start building. We name our interface, and the part that I found initially confusing here is that an interface consists of multiple pages. And I'm using that term only because I don't know the actual word of what we're supposed to call those things that are nested inside of the interface. So this is the overall interface, and I'm just going to call it overall interface for lack of a better word. If I want to put a description in, I can do that, and I go on to next. Now, inside of this overall interface can consist of multiple, again, what I'm going to call pages. And so we're going to create the first one of those now. So we say create new. In this case, I'm going to just start with the dashboard template because honestly, it's going to get us 95% of the way there. It's a great template and we can move it around and make changes as needed. Let's pop into the template and click next. And now the next part that we have to say is where does this data live? And of course, we've already talked about the fact that we are looking at sales data. And so we're going to make the transactions table where this interface is referencing. And you see that once we do that, it's smart enough and it's already saying, hey, we think this is going to be kind of what this is going to look like. It's a really nice feature. I'm going to click next and pop into the actual nitty gritty of how I want to set this up. Now, here's what this has assumed I want in this interface. A filter up at the top, followed by three numbers. And these are kind of like summary blocks. If you're familiar with blocks back in the day, now they're called apps. So if you're using a summary app or block, these are very similar to that. Also, I've got a bar chart here and I have a pie chart. I like this. This is a good setup, so I'm going to move on, click next. If I wanted to make any changes, I could have done so, and I can always add or take away elements from my interface as I'm going. So let's go ahead and call this one Sales Dashboard. And I'm gonna click Finish, and there it is. That quickly, it's populated. Bottom left corner is where I see all the different elements that I can add to this. If I wanna include text, bring in dividers, etc. Remember, we can add or take away elements as we'd like. But let's start at the very top of what we already have added to our setup. We have a filter here at the top, and if I click into it, you'll notice that it's connected to all of the other elements that are here inside of this dashboard. The three different numbers, number 1, 2, and 3, those are right here, then my chart, and then my chart 2, okay? And so I do want that because I wanna be able to, as I'm playing in my dashboard, I wanna be able to make changes and have my entire dashboard reflect whatever changes I make to my filter. This is a really powerful feature that I can't think of a good comparison to that exists out there in the marketplace today. I'm not saying it's not out there, just one doesn't readily come to mind. And I really enjoy this part of the Airtable interface designer. So let's go ahead and set up some filters. This way our users can change the data they're looking at with just a few clicks of their mouse. So first and foremost, let's look at the type of transaction we're looking at. If I just start typing type, I have an income type, an order type, a transaction type. I think order type is probably what I'm looking for here. So I'm going to allow our users to filter by order type. And they can decide if it's a development start, design, maybe they just want to look at development project data, whatever they want to do, they can filter that. This is a single select field inside of my transactions table. I'm going to add more filters though. Let's look at some paid date times. Let's see what we got here. I have a date time paid field. It's a date field. And I can say date time paid is on or after a certain date. And as I'm adding these filters here, they're showing up here on my interface. I can add another condition. Let's go with date time paid. Again here, I will say on or before. So here I've given my users, my interface users, three different things they can filter by. The type of transaction, the order type, and also dates and times. If they want to see certain data through a certain range of dates, they can plug it in here directly on the interface, and the rest of the data, because it's connected to this filter, these five different elements here, the rest of the data is going to reflect whatever they filter by. Really cool feature. Now that I'm set up on this filter, I'm going to shut it down and let's get into these numbers and do something fun with them. So right now I've got three different counts. Let's change it up. Let's say I want to see how many different transactions I had. Now in order to change this, I need to then go into here. Record count is what I'm looking for here, but I was able to change the text here, and I'll also change the color. Let's go with an orange here. That's perfect. All right, next, let's pop into this, and rather than doing another count right next to it, let's make this a total. Total sales volume for the given period that these filters are applying to. I'll change this to green because, I mean, money. And let's go to the field summary to set it up. Right now it's on account, but I need it instead to be something else. I'm gonna find the amount field, and again, summarize. How am I gonna do that? Well, I wanna see it by sum here at the top. Cool, that's working. And now lastly, maybe we wanna see an average ticket or an average transaction size for that particular range. So I'll go in here, make it light cyan, and I'll make this average transaction. Again, field summary, and I'll look at the amount again, and I will turn it over here to the amount. And this time, simple choice of average instead of summary. And this is looking perfect. So here we go. My three summary apps, or in this case, we call them number. These three elements are now showing up beautifully. So I've got transactions, total count. I have sales volume for the given period specified here. And I also have the average transaction size, again, based on the filters at the top. Now, just a couple more features that you might want to check out here. If I want to narrow this, I can shrink down these elements on this row. Just by selecting narrow, you see it bunches them together and scrunches them in the middle of the page here. Of course, I can always go back to the wide view. I can also decide if I want them to have a little bit more background here. So I can go with a gray background, and you'll see that that adds the gray directly behind the color for this particular element. Or I can just bring in another color behind that as well, if I so choose. I kind of like the no background here. It's a cleaner look. I'm going to stick with that. Move on now to the graphs. So very likely we're looking at sales data. We're probably going to want to track some sales over time. Bunch them up by month and year and track our sales. So let's pop into our first graph here. You'll notice that I can change the chart type. I keep saying graph, but Airtable actually uses the term chart to delineate this particular element. And we have an option of bar chart, line chart, scatter, pie, or donut. I like the bar for this example, so I'll stick with that. In terms of filter, I don't want to apply a filter to this particular element because I already have this meta filter that's affecting the entire dashboard for this particular page. So I'm going to stick with that and not apply filters at the graph or chart level. All right, let's pop into the fields. You know, field x-axis or your horizontal axis, this is where I'm going to want to break it down by the date. So I'm going to look at my year-month received, and I have my order, so the x value, and the direction is ascending. And down here on the y-axis, I'm going to want to look at the actual income. So again, I'm going to bring in that amount, and I will not want to average it. Of course, I will sum it for the given period. And if we want to group it, you can do that as well. So if you wanted to group it by certain things, you can do some grouping. In this case, I like it just how it is, so I'll stick with this. Another feature that I love is the ability to change color scheme. So color previously in Airtable was pretty limited. I think we had like 16 choices, maybe 32. Not exactly sure, but check this out. We've got way more options now. We can go crazy with these different color options. And honestly, it really opens up a whole new look and feel to the overall interface element. I'm kind of partial to Airtable colors now, so I'm going to stick with them. And let's go ahead and move on to the next part. In labels, I can label my x-axis, my y-axis. Now you'll see that they already received certain labels based on what I've selected here. I can change them if I need to total income, for example. But most importantly, I want to give this a title, sales over time, for example. And you see that that title shows up right here. So this chart, while it's very similar to the apps that we could build inside of Airtable directly, whole new level of cool that we're getting out of this. Honestly, it's tied to the filter, which is an incredibly powerful feature, way more aesthetically pleasing as we can change our color scheme. And I feel like we just have much more control over exactly how this data is going to show up. So let's go ahead and publish this interface because it's looking pretty good. I'm going to publish it and I want to take it out for a spin. Now, of course, you have to share your interfaces with people on your team that have access or will get access to your Airtable data. So this is, again, one of those key fundamental differences between using Airtable's interface designer and a tool like Softr or Stacker or some other third-party tool that allows you to create a true portal. A true portal is where your users don't have to actually log in and see all of your Airtable data. But if you're accessing interfaces, they get access to everything. So let's go ahead and publish these changes. If we wanted to add somebody here, we could add them. But again, they're going to get access to all the data. So be wary of that when you're bringing people in. All right, let's go ahead and pop into this actual dashboard now that we're set up. And we're going to take it out for a spin. This is what I'm talking about. We could add multiple pages of this inside of the overall interface, right? This is the overall interface that applies to this particular database, and the sales dashboard is merely one page inside of the overall interface. Now let's see those filters at work because this is the good stuff. Let's say I want to look at development projects. Now we can see sales over time only for those development projects. How many transactions we had, total sales volume, average transaction ticket for this particular type of order. And we can make changes here and it changes everything in real time. Number of transactions, sales volume, average transaction, because it's filtered now by that particular thing, right? I can also change it to is any of. So if I want to include multiple things, no problem. There's both of them, right? Really, really flexible and a very sleek design. I really think that this is an awesome new feature. Let's also plug in some dates and see. You know, this is really nice as well. We can actually get that calendar pop-up. I can say maybe July 1st, between July 1st and, you know, whatever today is. So we can look at essentially the second half of the year and see how things are going based on that. So lots of flexibility with this tool. I really love the interface. I love that we have the ability to have these filters right here directly in the interface. And I can't wait to start using this more and more for the larger organizations that we're working with. Let me know what your thoughts are on the interface designer, especially as it pertains to building a nice dashboard with some charts and some numbers and summaries. And I will catch you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.